Next, we're going to prove that the transformation just described does in fact reduce 3CNF satisfiability to independent set. We start by arguing that if F is satisfiable, then the output graph G has an independent set of size M. We'll let T be a satisfying assignment for F. In our example, let's take the one that makes A true, B false, C false, and D false. And we'll set the complements accordingly. Then we choose one literal from each clause in our original formula that is true under the truth assignment, and this will form our set S. So in our example, I might choose this A, this B bar, and this B bar here. Clearly, the size of this set is M, the number of clauses. Because the vertices come from distinct clauses, there can't be any within-clause edges. And because the truth assignment T doesn't contradict itself, there can't be any contradiction or between-clause edges either. Therefore, S must be an independent set. And indeed it is in this example. Let's prove the other direction next. If G has an independent set of size M, then the formula F is satisfiable. We start with an independent set of size M in the graph. Here I've marked an independent set in our example graph. The fact that there can be no between-clause edges in S implies that the literals in S come from distinct clauses. And the fact that there are no between-clause edges implies that the literals in S are non-contradictory. Therefore, any assignment consistent with the literals of F will satisfy the original formula F. Here, the choice of literals, A, B, and C, implies that A, B, and C all be true. We can set D however we like, true or false, and we still have a satisfying assignment. So that completes the proof that independent set is as hard as 3CNF. And that completes this chain here, showing that both independent set and vertex cover are NP complete. Now we're going to branch out, both in the tree here and in the type of arguments we'll make, by considering the subset sum problem.